Hey guys, Cookie38 here, and I'm back with Pathfinder. Now, a few announcements. First of all, sorry about last week, but weren't really enough of us here. Ideally, I wanted both frontline fighters here, and they are here this week. Nextly, there's no Ryan or Danielle this week, unfortunately. One other thing is that starting next week for a few weeks, I'm hoping at the very least, we're going to be taking a break from my Pathfinder game, and Will is going to be running a 5th edition D&D game. With Will's permission, I'll record that as well, and put it up as a separate campaign. And then after about a month or so, we're going to go into an alternate system where I'll do it one week, he'll do it the next, and just kind of do it like that. And one final announcement, we have an old new addition. I'm saying all new because he was originally a part of the group. He's dropped out for a while, but he has returned to the fold. Welcome back, Dakota. It's gonna be fun. So the lineup of characters, and I'm just waiting on. We've just spent a fair few hours making Dakota's character, not completely because we need to do his eidolon because he's a summoner, but we'll have to do it.
Picture,
enough time.
By the way.
Have you got a picture?
Yep.
Okay, cool. Right, so let's just grab this picture. 1 second. Character sprites. Okay. So, Dakota, would you like to introduce us to your character?
My character is a summoner gnome. He really hates other gnomes. I mean, to an extent. He doesn't like small things. He doesn't like being called small, even though he's known as Midge the Midget. And, yeah, he doesn't think he's actually a gnome. He just thinks he's a midget, but he's a gnome. That's about it, I guess. Looks big shit.
There he is.
Was that Will?
He looks very squashed as Midge the Midget. There's one thing that I think we can do, which is try and link. Can we?
Link. Hey, Will, I saw your picture when I was looking, or Adam, I saw your picture and I was looking for stuff. I mispicked it. Glad I didn't.
Well, actually, the good thing about this character sheet on Roll20 is that actually non-lethal damage is on there.
Knock some people out.
Right. I think there is a way to link up HP, but right. Right. 1 second. Sorry. One quick last thing that I'm doing. I'm just making sure Dakota can control this, which I believe he can. Alright, Dakota, can you try and just drag Midge the Midget? Just move him around.
Hold on. There we go.
Alright, brilliant. Alright, so, we're good to go. So, now most of us can't remember what's happened, like, massively in the past, but just to give Dakota, I'm just going to now give Dakota a very brief backstory as to what's going on, and then we'll take it from there. So, these guys are from a different land. Well, I say that, but Marceline and Jonathan technically are, but the original group from a different land who were sent over here because basically this land has fallen into turmoil for a seemingly unknown reason. So the king of the other land has hired adventurers to go over there and basically see what's up. Upon reaching there, they found mainly undead around the place. Taunting them and messing with them at every turn, such and such. The to cut a really long story short, basically they've gone to Natsgard, done a few done something, went up to Union City up there, did some more, they've been to Redwall, briefly to Haven, they've been at the Clockwork Fortress and helped the Elves of the Clockwork Forest, as Will called it, and now they're in Havergast, which is right there, because they know that basically a necromancer is doing all this, and he's got a minion called Fred Wu. And Fred Wu has been put in charge of Havergast, unbeknownst to everyone in Havergast, he is actually undead. So they're basically trying to help a resistance force fight him. They got trapped in his arena and fought some animals. They fought some giant hamsters, then some rhinos, then a couple of bears and an elephant, which Danielle annoyingly turned into a small creature.
Wait, they fought hamsters?
Giant hamsters, yeah.
Okay.
They're quite vicious. They're quite vicious bastards. Right, and then Fred Wu told them to be at his manor tomorrow night, and it will settle it with them then. And that was more or less where we left off.
Okay.
So, everyone seems to think it was they had gone back to the tavern. I'll assume that they did.
It was?
I'll assume that you did, just for the sake. So, and because, just so people know, normally we try and start this as close to 7 as possible, although normally it's closer to 8. We started this at about 10:15, because I'm making it the Kaiser. But hell, that's fine. So, as it stands, you guys have woken up the next morning, your showdown is approaching. One thing we need to think about, how are we going to introduce Midge the Midget to the party?
He's part of Resistance. There you go.
You know what? That's it. That works. That works.
I was about to say, he could just be a pissed off midget trying to fight him already when y'all show up or something.
Make you part of Resistance anyway.
No, that's fair enough.
I was thinking more along the lines of someone called him a midget and then he got real pissed off. Or no, someone called him a gnome and he got real pissed off.
Well, what are the party guys? Like, you fucking bastards. No, okay, so. You guys go downstairs from the time this morning. Normally at the moment, because what's going on in the tavern is basically empty. You actually notice that there is a pretty small gentleman sitting there, seemingly minding his own business, looking very cross. You don't know why, you've got no idea. He just doesn't look very happy. He's kind of clad in very, very fancy armor. But he doesn't seem to be carrying any kind of weapon. And I mean at all.
You're a real midget. You fight with your hands.
Yeah, punch me in the nuts. Punch me in the nuts.
You're perfect height for it. Give him a good old headbutt to the dang old lower head.
Yeah. So,
should I just be like, hey, I'm from the Resistance, and I'm here to fight the undead guy with you guys?
Well, at the moment, you're just kind of sitting there kind of crossed. They haven't really made a move at all. That's kind of coming down the steps. You would have noticed them, and you notice that they are, even the gnome that you see coming down the steps is a bit taller than you.
Wow, this is some shit.
Even
small man.
Hey.
Hey, look, I
see you
gnome.
Have a fellow midget in your group.
I'm a gnome.
No, you're a midget. Don't worry about it.
You're a gnome.
You don't know what you're talking about. You're uneducated. Don't worry. Midget.
I'm a gnome.
Midget.
I'm a gnome. I do gnomey stuff.
Hold on here. Give me a minute.
What are gnomey stuff?
Oh. Just get drunk. Fall asleep in the
crazy. I think you should just leave it.
I'm gonna do a knowledge history on the history of midgets, and I'm gonna say the midget.
You see why we love Dakota, guys. Come on.
Oh, god damn it.
The history of midgets that you know of is that people of your kind have been called midgets before, and that's why you refer to yourself as a midget as opposed to a gnome. And by gnome standards, you are smaller than and you are pretty sure as a kind of your competitive standard gnome. So does that as well. But okay. Other than that, though, you know,
given my extensive knowledge on midget history, you're a midget.
You're a gnome. You're of a small gnome, but you're a gnome.
I think he needs to do a knowledge check on the gnome history.
What knowledge would it be?
History.
Oh.
You've seen when he used. Are you trained in knowledge history?
No.
Yeah. You don't know anything about gnome history, really. You know that your people are small, and that's it. Really.
Seems like you might be a midget, sir.
Okay, that's what we call them. They're both small people.
Anyway,
what are you doing here, man?
I'm with the resistance here to fight the undead guy.
As you say that, the bartender kind of looks up and goes,
"Hey, you mind your own business, bartender."
he starts making his way into the back.
We should probably stop him.
Leave.
This is the worst member of resistance ever. I'm part of the resistance.
Oh, I didn't know it was a secret. I just joined, man. I'm out of town. Does that mean should we kill him or something? Or
kill an innocent person?
But he's about to snitch. That doesn't make him innocent. That makes him a snitch, you know?
Or we can just get Jonathan to make him wet himself.
Yeah.
Jonathan does seem to be good at that.
Well, just follow him in, just fucking scare him.
Maybe he just went to the loo. Who knows what he's doing back there.
Make sure we're not compromised, even though Fred knows exactly what we're doing. We're
just going to fight
him. I think he knows we're with the resistance now, doesn't he? Well, we're going out to kill him anyway.
Knows exactly what's going on.
Yeah.
So whether he thinks we're in the resistance or not, doesn't really matter.
Yeah, it doesn't.
Okay then, let's go, gang! Big guy, can I get up on them shoulders, see the view from up there? You know what I'm saying?
Why would a tall guy such as you want to get up on shoulders?
I just met you.
Are you sure? Can I do a... What's the role for, persuasive? Is that even a thing?
It'd be diplomacy that it'd come under.
Damn, dude.
Can I do anything against him?
I mean, the success rate. No. I mean, that is a good role, but it's one of those things where you know, would Jonathan want the guy on his shoulders at all?
I just met him.
Well, the answer is getting on my shoulders.
I gave you the compliment. You're a big old tough guy.
Yeah.
Seeing all the nice weather around up there, I'm just curious.
Yeah.
Being a midget and all.
Alright then.
By the way, Dakota, just so you know, you can, on the character sheet, you can literally just click the dice next to diplomacy and it just makes the roll for you, like that.
Oh shit.
Yeah, that's kind of the whole point of the character sheet. You just kind of go, okay, I'm making a ranged attack. I've, rolled an 18. You rolled a 27 for bluff. Jesus, bloody Christ.
Dang. Too bad. Wasn't bluffing earlier.
Yeah. But yeah.
Okay, so how am I getting up on your shoulders? You helping me up? Am I climbing? What's going on?
Oh, fuck it.
Sweet.
As you picture, luckily, because it is a small gnome, I mean, the roof isn't that high up. Really? Luckily, he's a small gnome, so.
I am fucking tall.
You are tall, You're 7 foot tall, and you can't teach that. Yep, I had to, sorry. But yeah. Even with the gnome on top of your shoulders, it still doesn't reach ceiling.
Fucking hell, it's a tall ceiling.
It's probably about 10 foot up, so it's probably about a foot away from the ceiling. You could not do this with someone else.
Okay.
Aww. Hear that, other midget?
Wow.
Special treatment.
Oh, due to in her character, Willow would be kind of asking a load of questions to Midge, and wanted to be Midge's friend. Cause that's Willow's character. That's what she does.
I'm gonna ride on my zone. On someone else's shoulders.
Yeah, she probably would actually. Yeah, she actually goes up to you, Master Lean, and asks if she can go on his shoulders.
Roll my eyes and let her up.
But, okay, how tall is Master Lean, by the way?
Like. Six.
6 foot. That's still some foot pretty tall. But yeah. When Willow gets on his shoulders, they're technically a bit smaller than Midge being on Jonathan's shoulders.
Wait, she's smaller than me?
No, well, no.
Oh,
well, there's that as well, but it's also Marceline is 6 foot and Jonathan is 7. And Mitch is like, what, 2 foot something? Willow's probably...
No, he's 3 foot, thank you very much.
Oh, 3 foot! Okay, oh, sorry, 3 foot. So, in that case, then, sorry, Mitch, your head would just about be touching the ceiling when standing on Jonathan's shoulders. You could reach up and touch the ceiling if you wanted to.
Sweet.
We're gonna get through the door.
It's good to be big. I mean, we could just kind of like, you know, push the wall a bit, you know, break it and get by if we need to. I mean, he is snitching on us right now.
This guy
causes necessary damage.
This guy is gonna be a great fit to the party. Yeah, let's just wreck shit. It doesn't matter.
Well, no, he's snitching. He started it. Starting problems with Midge to Midget. We'll fuck up your tavern. You know what I'm saying, dog?
Not really.
Okay, well, are we leaving them to go do some battles or what?
Right. You guys will obviously remember that Fevy wants you there in the evening for the final climactic showdown. Is there anything you guys want to do in the meantime? Anything at all? Like, I don't know, heal?
Yeah, maybe.
I mean.
I'm probably going to save my laying hands for a fight, but I'm going to go buy some potions right now.
Okay, who are you going to go to buy potions?
What's her name, Lily?
Lily. Oh, herbal things.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lady. I'll go with him, just so I can stock him.
I also need some, like, silver dust as well.
I'm also on a shoulder, so I'm going with him.
Some silver dust.
Yeah.
Okay,
it's for a spell.
You know you probably won't be able to get that off Lily. You would have to go to either Victor or Gustav.
I can't go to Victor anymore.
Why, what happened with Victor?
I rolled a natural 20 on Intimidate and he kinda killed hurt himself quite a bit.
He pissed himself, shit himself, and then fainted and fell down and fell backwards and cracked his head open.
Well, if he's still alive...
He is alive, yes.
Well, then I can go and buy it for you if you want.
He's kind of crazy, though.
That's fine. I think Midge the Midget's scared of a crazy old man. Midge the Midget ain't scared of nobody!
You know what? Yeah.
Snapping him like a Slim Jim.
I don't know how much fucking silver dust is.
Do you want to just check how much it is for... Because I'm assuming it's for a spell.
Yeah, it's for a spell. I just need a pinch of it, but I won't get a...
Wait. Just a pinch.
Yeah, a pinch of silver dust is for the spell, but I want more.
Would recommend is getting a spell component pouch, which would cost 5 gold, weighs 2 pounds, and any spell components which do not have a specific gold value after it, it counts as being in there. Just
how many are in there though?
Infinite. It doesn't say, so I'm assuming infinite.
Then I can just give him some.
It's one of us. I think it's one of those things where the way I see it is, it's kind of like a magical pouch where, you know, it actually, like, you know, detects the spell that you're trying to cast and then does it like that. So if he was holding the pouch, then it would work. But you obviously need that pouch for some of your own spells.
Well, I'll be able to get that off Victor.
Either Victor, probably Gustav, actually, would probably be your best bet for that.
What about that other lady? She sells healing potions, but she don't sell the pouches?
But, Well, she specializes more in, like, herbal medicine, more than actual potions. So, and kind of herbal remedies. So, actually, Lily probably wouldn't be the one to go to for potions. Again, it would actually probably be Gustav is your best bet for potions. Because, you know, if you remember those smoke sticks, those special order smoke sticks that you ordered from him. Yeah. He kind of specializes in alchemy like that. So, he would be the one to go to in that regard.
Hey, Aaron, have we left the establishment yet?
Yeah, you kind of just walk in. To get to any of them, you've got to kind of go into a central area and then kind of branch off when you need to go, so you're kind of discussing while talking. So, discussing and talking while walking, sorry.
Or shoulder riding.
Yeah, or shoulder riding. What's everyone else doing, by the way?
I was going with Jonathan to the healing lady.
Yeah, I guess so.
But she's...
Did everyone introduce themselves to me, or do I not even know any of these people's names?
Welcome to how the party works, Dakota. You should know this by now. You used to be part of this a long time ago, remember?
Well, yeah, I know, but you used to call us out when we used to not do this stuff. You haven't said anything now, so I'm like, maybe it counts.
I turn to the midget sat on Jonathan's shoulders, turning Willow with me because she's on my shoulders, and I'm like, hey, Marceline. And then shake his hand.
Hey, Midge! The midget! This is the
Willow
midget!
Willow goes...
The kid's called Willow.
Yeah. What's Willow's dragon called? It's Cinders, isn't it? Cinders.
Cinders, yeah.
Yeah, you will notice that, by the way, Midge. You'll notice kind of a little dragon on Willow's shoulder, and which will be introduced to you as Cinders.
What do dragons speak?
Draconic.
I don't know Draconic, do I?
No, you don't.
It's up for a big race. Should have known better, should have learned it.
No, you're no giant and orc, you're fine. And you chose another, didn't you? I can't remember what you chose. I know, it's on your character sheet, I could just play check while you're just roleplaying. It's fine. It was...
I'm gonna introduce myself to everyone before we split up.
Oh, it was Treant. I don't think you are split up, I think you're going to the same place anyway.
Okay, well, off we go.
By the way, Dan, how many shots do you have left for your gun?
Oh, 12.
12, okay.
Yeah, I did aim like that powder shot last time I had to go try and speak to a thingy.
Victor.
Yeah.
Yeah, you haven't met Victor yet, and you might not want to.
He might fucking bump into me again.
Yeah. Okay, well, are you all going to Gustav then? Who is just actually opposite Victor, so...
Yeah.
Right, okay, so as you get there, you notice that there are a couple of people working on the roof of Victor's house.
Right.
So there's that. However, there is a sign on Victor's door, which, can you all make me perception checks, please, to read from across the street?
Shit, dude.
The writing is fairly small. Oh my god, Jonathan.
Which...
It's the only time I'll ever get a 19 on perception.
For some of that's pointless, really.
Yeah.
I mean, honestly, you can just make the standard roll if you feel like making the standard roll, but those kind of sheets actually do the rolls for you. Oh, God!
Yeah, boy.
No! Oh, my goodness! Okay, so everyone will see it. The sign says, taking days off to recover from a near-death experience. We'll open back up in 2 weeks.
So we couldn't go to fucking Victor's anyway.
No, you couldn't.
Hey, who says we have to take no for an answer? Just bang the door till he comes out.
You do see the door, actually, while you're looking over, kind of open slightly, and Victor pop his head out and go, and kind of look up at the people and go, is it done? Are you finished? Like, Victor, we started about 20 minutes ago. No, we are not finished. Well, tell me when! Well, tell me when. Don't you have something you could be doing, Victor? Well, no, I don't want to leave the house right now. Why not? Why not? It's not like there's someone scary out here who's going to make you, you know, faint. faint. There is! There's a monster about! I swear! I saw it with my own eyes! He did this to me! Can I tap him back? And he said, ow! Ow! Oh, I swear! It's a monster in the form of a man!
In the head.
Man, he looks like that! Man, stabs the door shut, goes back inside. Like, whoa, Victor, whoa! Because the slamming of the door causes the ladder that the guy's on to kind of rock slightly. So it's like, whoa, Victor, what are you doing? Calm down. I don't want to be cut me head open as well.
I just realised something.
What?
My character has just grey skin.
Hmm?
So I look kind of odd.
Yeah.
You look like a demon.
Because I'm a race.
Right. What race are you guys?
Fetchling.
What's Marceline? I keep forgetting what Marceline is.
Dampier.
Dampier. Okay, yeah, fair. Sorry.
Half vampire.
Okay, so Gustav is there. The door is open.
Well, it looks like he's home, guys. We can just go get it from him now.
Not Victor. Gustav is something different.
Oh, well, my bad. I mean, he's there. We could technically go in and buy it from him. Like, I'm assuming his house is his shop, right? You just walk in, put the money on the counter, walk out with what we need. It's not stealing.
You mean Victor? The others would know that Victor would not sell things like potions.
It'd be overpriced anyway if he did.
Yeah. I don't know whether they actually want to tell you what he dabbles in, but...
Explosive powder.
Ooh!
He likes black powder and then items that are seemingly... like magic items that are basically useless. To put it bluntly.
Oh, wow, that is helpful.
Because apparently Ryan just had a list of them and just went, I kind of want these. I'm like, okay, fine, if you want to waste your gold.
Okay, well, I'm riding the shoulder, so yeah, wherever legs beneath me takes. Okay,
so Jonathan goes into the shop. Does he duck?
I mean, I think I would.
Right, okay, so you duck enough to get me...
Try to, anyway.
...through the door.
It's duck anyway to go into the doorway.
No. To go through the door, he kind of would. The door is probably, and at most, maybe 8-9 feet up. Midge on Jonathan's shoulders is about 10 feet.
That's pretty...
I mean, like, if I'm sitting on his shoulders, I'm only 3 feet tall. I can't put that much on.
Yeah, but he's 7 foot tall himself. So that's another 3 foot on top of that, more or less.
No, but I'm sitting, so...
You're sitting. Okay. So you might... You might have to bend down a little bit just to make sure, but you'll get through just fine. You enter the property, you see Gustav kind of sitting at the car, kind of like, seemingly experimenting with, like, some potions, like, pouring them into each other, and as you walk in, and the bell the door rings, he looks up, and feels to pour the potion into the other potion, into, like, you know, like, the other test tube, pours it on the desk, and he starts melting his counter. Damn it! Yes, how can I help? Who are you again? Oh, yeah, those guys who want the smoke sticks. Yeah, I remember you. How can I help?
I need a spell component pouch.
A spell component pouch.
And a few health potions.
What manner of health potions do you require? Moderate ones, and how many would you be wanting?
All of them.
That's not very specific.
No, it is all of them. It's pretty specific.
Five for you? Does anyone else want any potions of any kind?
Yeah.
How many?
Some moderate ones. What did you got?
How many do I have? Let me just go check. And he stands up and he goes into the back as his table is still dissolving in front of you. He comes back. You hear a lot of, like, loud banging in the back. Then you hear rah, and a cat kind of come darting out. Which Willow tries to chase, but forgetting that she's on Marceline's shoulders. Marceline, can you make me a... We'll go... Acrobatics? I'd go athletics, but that's 5th edition, so...
Wouldn't it be reflex, maybe?
Go reflex.
Oh, that's way better.
Yeah, I imagine it would be.
Okay.
You have enough wear of it all to kind of like, as she starts like pulling away and pulling you to one side, kind of like grab hold of her, put her straight, and go, you're on my shoulders.
Yeah, I think we're though. See, the difference is that if it was in acrobatics, that would have been a negative 4.
What? What's that? Would have been 6?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, because you're heavy armor. Yeah.
I'm a check penalty.
Oh, yeah, that's fair enough. Yeah, that's fair enough. Okay, so a couple of minutes later, Gustav comes back carrying a very small chest, and he opens it up, and he goes, right, are these all my healing potions? Let's just see how many I've got. And that's kind of it. Looks like I've got about 25 for sale at the moment.
Well, how much for one?
Oof, about 300 gold for one.
What? God damn.
This isn't me.
The moderate, right?
Yeah, yeah.
That's the only one up from light. This, Jesus.
This isn't me actually ripping you off. That's actually what it is.
Aaron, you were fucking selling me 300 fucking gold for a moderate potion earlier, you bastard.
Yeah, no, so I'm doing it now for them.
Hmm. I think I might go down to light.
Yeah, how much is light?
Light potions. Light. The lighter potions, not the lesser ones. They would be 50 gold apiece.
Oh wow,
that's more doable. I'll take 5 of those.
5 of those, okay. Does anyone actually want any of these, or should I take them away?
I'll have 2 of them.
You have 2 of these, okay.
Yep.
So, do you want any of the light ones as well, or?
Yeah, I'll take like 5 light.
5 of the light ones and 2 of these. Okay, so he picks out 2 and he hands them over to you and he goes, here you go. Does anyone else want any of these ones before I take them away?
Nope.
No.
Okay.
Nah, I'm good. Okay then. I'll be right back. He closes the lid. He puts it under the counter, which is still melting.
Dude, wait, what? It's still melting. Take it away.
What?
The counter's still melting.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Can someone do something about that? I'll just take these away. And he grabs the box, kind of goes in the back. Goes, now where did I put those? Now where did I put those ones? They should be in the same spot. Ah, here they are. Why did I put them up there? You evil twat. Sorry. So, what happened up there? Almost got it.
Oh, yeah. I forgot to detect evil on this motherfucker on my shoulders. What am I doing? I should have checked that earlier.
Hey, I'm not
evil right now.
Are you kidding me?
Is evil, mate? Is he fucking glowing red?
he is not glowing red.
Okay.
He is not glowing red.
Guy.
No, you don't know. He's just detected evil on you.
I just kind of like looked around. That's like you saw.
I'm on your shoulders. You're looking real awkward if you're trying to look at me.
Well, I only have to look at your legs that are going on my shoulders.
I guess that's true.
Okay. All of a sudden, you hear a mighty clattering in the back. And we go, ow, ow, ow! Damn it!
Guess we should go check on him.
I'm fine. I'm good. I'm coming out. I'll be out in a minute. As he steps out, he seems to step on something, and all of a sudden, a billow of smoke comes out of the back, and he goes, "Oh, not again!" Oh god, you seem kind of like running out. He's like, "Huh, Well, how do I know about?
You're a hazard to yourself.
I'm gonna tap Andy on the shoulder and be like, "Oi, big guy, is every alchemist in this entire town a klutz?"
Seems it.
Right. Okay, here we go, we've got 12. So how many did you say you want? You said you each wanted 5 each?
Yeah.
And did anyone else want any? 10. Oh, you want 10? Okay, let's have a look. And he goes, oh. Some of these things were broken. Perhaps from when I fell over. Hang on. He kind of sits, ow, kind of cuts himself, and kind of goes, right, the usable ones, I've got about 8 left. Sorry, most of them broke.
Some of them.
I'll stick to 5.
You stick to 5, so does that mean you want the other 3?
Yeah, I'll take the other 3.
Okay, so in total, including those 2 slightly better ones, that will be 750 gold from you, sir, and then 250 from you, big sir.
Alright, hand over.
Okay, thank you very much. Pleasure to do business. Can I put it there?
What about the pouch?
That is actually a good point, sir. That's actually a good point. I'm so sorry, I completely forgot with all the commotion about there. Give me a second, I think I've got one. Actually, near the front somewhere, he kind of goes to the other side of the counter that isn't melting, and kind of looks under there and he goes, here we go. Well, here is the pouch. You actually look at the pouch, it actually looks pretty underwhelming. It just looks like a standard little pouch that you might just put like a few coins in. He goes, now, I know this doesn't look like much, but it's actually magical. Now, what it does is, and he basically explains what I just explained to you earlier, with the whole kind of, you know, more or less kind of like, you know, it detects, you know, from the magic that you're trying to cast, what material components you need, if it's like a small thing, and then just automatically puts it in the spell for you.
Okay.
So that is another 5 gold from you, please, sir.
Okay.
I hand it over.
I thank you very much. So, is there anything else that anyone else wants? No? Okay.
How much do these potions heal?
Okay.
1d8 plus...
It's 1d8 plus 1 for Cure Light, and 2d8 plus 3 for Moderate.
1d8 plus 1.
Yes. With potions, it always counts as being made of the lowest level. So, because you're normally with Cure Light Wounds, it's 1d8 plus up to 5, up to, plus caster level, maximum 5.
Mm.
However, a potion version is just 1d8 plus 1. Because the 1 is the minimum caster level that someone needs to be to make that potion. Okay?
Yeah. I'm gonna down one.
You're gonna down one now?
Yeah.
That takes you almost to max.
I'm gonna throw Marceline too.
Literally throw.
Oh, you know, pass them over.
Yeah, but I was about to say. Alright, Marceline, you've been passed a couple of Cure Light Wound potions. Is Will around, or is he gone off somewhere? Or is he muted?
He just doesn't care. Just silently nods.
It's like,
I was waiting while you were doing stuff.
Oh, that's okay. Right, you've just been passed 2 Cure Light Wound potions.
Sweet. I don't have to pay, though.
No, I don't think so. I don't know, that's Jonathan.
I earned nearly a grand, so I'm not paying for anything.
This is just substituting my healing, so I can save it for later.
Right, so it's d8 plus 1 per potion, by the way.
It's what now?
D8 plus 1 per potion.
Okay.
And you're currently 11 down. Is Thardin using any?
I've still got some healing sweets.
You do still have a healing sweet, which is d8 plus 5.
Oh, cool. I'll have one of the sweets.
Alright. So you want to roll and do the healing? Oh wow! That sweet was good! That sweet was good! Is Marceline? Is Marceline having any of the cure light wound potions?
Yeah, I guess I'll eat one.
Well, it's not eat. Glass
of
all.
Unless you're, biting on the glass.
Two.
I heal two.
Yay! that was not a very effective healing potion.
That's why I passed two, just in case.
I chug another. And I heal seven.
That's alright.
That's better.
That's... Bussy, you're all pretty close to being max, so that's not too bad. Right, so... Is there anything else that you guys want to do before the climactic fight?
I need to go pray, change my spells.
You need to go change your spells. Well, in the morning, you would have a chance to change spells.
Okay.
When you first woke up, that's how it works usually. You wake up, after a long rest, you wake up, and then you have to spend an hour preparing your spells.
Okay.
Yeah, alright, go to the armor.
What, the armor place?
Yeah, armor.
Okay, sure. Go ahead.
I now need to find a list of armor. Shit.
Is this like magic stuff, like different materials and shit?
Well, yeah, I'm wanting to see what armor there is too.
Can you wear medium armor yet?
Yeah.
Medium armor without penalty from a Magus. Nice.
Yeah.
Right, hang on. I'll drop you. Have you got the armor thing there, or do you want me to drop you a link?
You drop me a link because I'm having a.
Right, yeah, that's for the armor. And then kind of the whole magic thing is kind of like the plus ones or like Dakota with like any kind of specialist material you want.
Right. I'm sure. Where's the? Oh wait, it's at the end.
What, sorry?
I was about to say, where's the weight, but it's at the end.
Yeah. Actually, while you're just having a look, I do actually want to check something.
Aaron.
Yeah?
I can't wear any medium and have the overweight.
It's one of those things where sometimes you just kind of have to. I mean, like Dakota is over the light load.
I'm already over my. Yeah, I'm over already over light load, so it don't matter.
Yeah.
I was looking at the wrong thing. Yeah, so I'd still be at the same speed.
Yeah.
Wearing an armored coat, would that add to my or existing armor or take away or just be the armored coat?
I think with the armored coat.
When you're wearing an armored coat over armor, it just takes whatever's the highest.
Yeah, rating. Yeah, use the better AC and worst value in all other categories.
So, armored shield bonus would be +4, right?
Yes. But honestly, it's one of those things where, you know, I suppose I can see the use for it. I mean, the main thing is, you can, because with most armor, you need time to kind of put it on and take it off. With an armored coat, you just kind of go, okay, now it's on, now it's off.
Yeah. I mean, it's only, +2 better than what mine is currently.
Hmm. And an armored coat does count as metal. So you can make it out of things like mithril and things like that.
I don't have anything to...
The armored coat would reduce your speed to technically 15, unless the being in medium does that anyway.
Yeah, it's that anyway. Yeah, so if I get like an armored coat and make it, could I pay to make it masterwork straight away?
Yeah, to be honest, if you wanted the coat to be masterwork, you'd have to pay straight away for it to be masterwork. You can't buy.
No.
Yeah, you can't buy something and then make it masterwork afterwards.
Right.
So essentially you want to go to this guy and make a masterwork armoured coat.
Yeah.
Okay, but what armour do you have at the moment?
Padded, I think, and some braces.
All padded in the braces?
Yeah.
Okay, so really the padded only gives you plus one.
The assistant plus two. Padded master, that's why.
No, but the masterwork doesn't give you an additional one to AC. It reduces the armature penalty by one, which it doesn't even have anyway, and opens the way to making it magical. It's the braces give you plus one, don't they?
Yeah.
Right. So yeah. So you go see the armorer. He is currently hard at work. Just looking like he's finishing off some suits of armor. And he goes, and he stops and looks over his shoulder, and he goes. Ah, a customer. Can I put it in work? Apologies for how I look. Welcome to my humble store. How can I help you today?
Hi, I'd like a masterwork armoured coat, please. One green one to match my outfit.
Okay. Any particular style, or...? Well, what I could do, sir, if you wanted it to match your outfit, is I could... let's have a look. Should I? Actually, no. It's probably best if I made it from scratch. So you want an armoured coat that kind of looks like the one that you've currently got.
I don't think I am wearing a coat.
Right. Oh, that's the thing, by the way. Did everyone leave the store and go with Valden?
Yeah.
I don't see why not.
Right, now, I can't... I can't play what you want me to play, Dakota.
That's fine. You're gonna have to say what it is. I'm sure everyone will.
Nah, the next thing, they won't be able to hear it over my speakers. So if you want to play it, for everyone's enjoyment.
No, I'm saying you just need to say what it is.
Okay. So as you guys leave, you start hearing some kind of music and singing coming from back inside Gustav's.
The fuck.
You can't see anything, you hear some kind of, almost like ghostly voices saying, hello my baby, hello my honey, and it's kind of going like that. And you see that, Gustav looked absolutely freaked the fuck out, has no idea what's going on.
Yo, Gustav's weird, let's go.
Right, so with the armor coat. So the masterwork armored coat. Any magical enhancement on it?
What magical enhancements are there?
To start with, before anything else can go on, that you need to make it kind of give it some kind of minor magic property, which would also mean that it would help protect you a little more. After that, that's when you can start putting things on, but that's when it starts getting very expensive. You could also, if there's like a certain material that you might want it made out of, I could do that for you as well, although it might take a bit longer for me to get the material depending on what it is. I suppose it depends what your budget is.
5,000 gold.
How many, sorry?
5,000 gold and 15 platinum, if you accept platinum.
And 15 platinum? Oof.
And 5,000 gold.
15 platinum and 5,000 gold. He's kind of just thinking like, Well, what I could do for you is... That's a bit... Hold up! Could you just... Hold on a second, sorry. I just would like to go check something real quick. And he kind of... He goes in back and goes, now, do I have enough of this? Yeah, I think I just about have enough of this. And he comes back out, and you can see that in his hands, he has brought out, holding his hands, like, raw mithril. And he goes, well, as I'm sure you know, this is mithril. It's a very lightweight material, but tough as nails. What I could do for you is I have a friend who is from Valengard who I could send for, who could come and enhance the coat, not the lowest peg, but the one after that, and I could make it out of this material, which would make it a lot lighter. It would mean that, you know, your natural agility could come out and could help you in a fight, you know, avoid blows, and it would also weigh probably about half as much as the coat would normally weigh. Unfortunately, if you want that, it would take all of your money, pretty much all your gold, and it would take probably about 5 days to complete.
Sounds amazing. I will give you all my gold.
Okay. I would also ask for 7 platinum alongside the gold to make up, because it would cost about 5,050 gold. So that 7 platinum would make it up with kind of what I'm going to lose when the bank exchanges it out.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't think you have that much gold on your person. It would be in your wagon.
Yeah. I, at the moment, don't want to pay all of it up front, so can I give you half gold?
I tell you what. Making it a masterwork quality, and I will actually check the actual, I think it's 150 to make it masterwork. Yeah, okay, I tell you what, here's what I'll do for you. If you pay 200 gold now, I will make your armored coat, and it will be masterwork, and I will have it done probably actually by the end of today. I could probably have it done before the evening, before I close up. And in the meantime, I will send a message to my friend in Valengard and ask him to come over to enchant and enhance the armor when he gets here. So if you pay me 200 gold now, yeah, and then pay me the remaining 4,850 gold when my friend, sorry, it would actually be 1,200 gold because of the materials, and then it would be the remaining 3,850 gold when my friend got here to enchant it.
Okay, that's cool.
Right. That does mean, though, that you wouldn't actually have, because of the materials, because I want to make sure I get this right, I would not actually be able to have it by today, I'm afraid. It would be tomorrow. That would be the only downside to be making it out of mithril.
Yes.
But it will be worth it in the end. You'll have to make do with your light, fairly ineffectual armor. No offense.
I've been saving up.
You've been saving up. I think that was a very good choice, sir. And personally, just my personal opinion, the big weakness of armor, in my opinion, is that it takes, especially like the heavy armor that the two kind of taller figures of your group of friends have, It takes a while to get off, and usually they actually need help, don't they? Whereas this, you just slip it on and off as and when you want to.
Yeah.
And also, because it's made out of mithril and it's lighter than normal, it won't actually feel that much different, at least in terms of the weight of it, than what you're currently wearing.
Yeah.
So do we have a deal? He sticks out his hand, which is covered in kind of like sweat and dirt from like when he's been like hammering on the anvil and such.
I go and shake his hand.
Well, you do shake his hand.
Yeah.
Okay. Goes right. Okay. Pleasure to do business. I'll send for my friend, and I will get started after the initial payment.
Okay. Remember what the initial payment is.
It was 1,200 gold, sir.
Okay, I pay the 1,200.
Okay, thank you very much. This also is actually advantageous for yourself, because I know that you were just shy on the right amount of gold for the full amount, which is why you wanted this deal. If you get any gold before my friend arrives, which will probably take him, even if it's by wagon, it'll probably be a couple of days. It'll probably be about 3 days, and that 3 or 4 days, and that includes the time it will take to get the message over there before he arrives back. So if you come across any more gold in the meantime, you will then not have to pay platinum. You can just pay the gold as standard. Okay, especially to do business, right? Right. Does anyone else have any other business here? No. Mm-hmm. Right, okay. I will get started as soon as I can, and it should be ready by probably about. Well, the initial code would be ready by midday tomorrow, if you needed to use it. Other than that, when my friend gets here, it'll probably take him about 4 days. So, in probably about 8 days' time, your armored coat should be ready.
Yeah.
Okay, and with that, he turns around, gets the mithril, and starts the smelting process to smelt the mithril. Anything you guys want to do before the climactic fight again?
I can't
even think of. I think everyone's prepared now.
Yeah, I'm ready. Ready.
Okay, so, the one thing that Fribble did not tell you was what time he wanted you there. So, do you just go back to the tavern for the meantime?
Yeah.
I don't think that's the best place to go.
Oh, because you revealed you were resistance.
Well. Just walking kind of towards the center of town, you see there's a lot of guards there, and they're all looking straight at you.
At me?
Yeah. Well, just at you guys in general. And just kind
of, I'm gonna start looking around, seeing if I can see what they're looking at.
You. You. But
I'm still looking for what they're looking at, because I know they're not looking at Mitch!
I'm Mitch. Mitch, you guys go.
Mitch the midget.
One of the guards approaches you. As you're walking towards him, and he goes, go away to the tavern. We'll be back for you at 9 to escort you to see Frederick Wu.
Woohoo!
Don't try and leave town.
Don't worry, not going nowhere.
Don't plan to.
Okay, so if no one's doing anything else, it gets to 9. But is anyone having like anything to eat or drink before they go? Just a quick ask.
Just general sustenance.
I have an idea actually. Essentially, is anyone getting pissed?
Oh no.
Oh, no.
I don't think that's the best idea. Watch now, Midge is a raging alcoholic.
He saw another gnome. It's all fun memories.
Not quite.
He's a mild alcoholic?
Not at all.
We'll put it this way. Are people just wanting like a few, just like a meal?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just eat.
Yeah.
Okay, hang on. Okay, so, Right, 1 second, so I see a look at jumping. Okay, so as you guys kind of get to tavern and kind of just real quick, sorry, what are people just want? Are people just wanting like a meal before they go?
Yeah.
So what kind of meal? Yeah. Poor, common, good? What you wanting today?
Give me good.
What?
Yeah. I want good.
I'm coming.
Okay, so first things first. Who wants poor?
What?
No one wants paw? No. Okay, common.
Yeah.
So, the ones who want common, that is 3 silver, and you get bread, chicken stew, carrots, and watered down wine or ale. And who wants good?
Scrumptious.
And it was Jonathan and Mitch who wanted good, yeah? Right, so yours costs you 5 silver. But that gets you bread and pastries, beef, peas, and full-on ale or wine.
Sweet. Give me that ale.
Where's my, gold?
It's, like, right at the bottom of the sheet. Yeah. Bottom. Yeah, it's right at the bottom. So as you guys, kind of, like, as you guys are, like, sitting on the bar, just kind of, like, eating your meals,
it costs 5, right?
Yes, 5 silver, yeah. 5 silver. It's why you need a lot of silver. You hear a quite loud pitch screech, kind of from near the bartender, who looks like he just like jumps really quickly, and then he kind of like just looks around, doesn't see anything. Screeching is still happening. He kind of walks away, and then screeching just seems to follow him around.
What the fuck? Some crazy shit going on. I'm detecting evil over there.
You don't detect anything. Don't detect any evil. Mm.
This town is cursed.
Okay, after... It doesn't last for long. After about 35 seconds, it seems to go away. The bartender looks very perturbed. And he goes, was that you, guys?
No.
Was that snitch? Get out of my face!
Hey, I ain't no snitch.
Hey, don't make me come back there, bartender boy.
Also, is Midge, like, eating on the top of my shoulders?
Right, of course. Plates resting on the head.
What the fuck? I mean, Jonathan wouldn't care, but still.
No, no. Will have got off Marceline's shoulders. Right, so, so you have your meals, and then at about 10 to 9, you see about 2 dozen guards enter the tavern and go, it's time. They have hands at the ready on weapons in case you try anything.
Wait,
father?
I gotta go to the toilet.
Yeah, yeah, okay. Okay, yeah. Oh, yeah, you have the food, just goodbye. I'm just gonna actually call a quick 5-minute toilet break. Right, and then we'll start the climactic fight afterwards, okay? Right,
are you still gonna be recording us as you're gone?
Yeah, in case any of you guys just talk, because it picks you up. Right, have fun.
Oh, you mean so when he leaves, he always hears our insults later on?
I mean, your insults, Michael, you friggin' you meanie poo-poo stinkhead. Yeah, I said it.
I mean, yeah, it hurts.
Should.
That was a big insult, dude.
Yeah, I know, I'm sorry. God damn, I forget what I used to say all the time.
I don't know.
Andy, if anyone in here would have heard, it would have been you.
I can't remember.
It was something head. A big old dum-dum head.
Oh.
Big old dum-dum head. So, anyone else curious on why they had to bring in, like, the clown posse for, you know, making sure we showed up?
It's Fred Wu. It's kind of weird.
Yeah.
Fred Wu.
They've already killed him once. Well.
Yeah, and we're not, like, very reliable, so...
You're not?
I think he just wants to make sure we're there. Plans never work.
I mean, we got it done in the end. That's the end result is all that matters. How many people die or villages get burned down is...
Dang, y'all are burning really down matter. Villages?
Alright, I'm back.
We've only done that once. Everyone, let's do it again.
Hang on, what? wait, what I let you do?
You'll find out in the video.
Oh, got him!
Oh, you evil twats! You evil twats! It means I actually have to watch it all back, you sons of bitches. damn you. Right, so just real quick, so in Will's game, we've all agreed that we'll start at level 1 just because it's easier to make level 1 characters.
Sure.
Okay.
Right.
Indifferent.
That's fair enough. Right, and sometime before the next time we have a session in this for my campaign to go, we'll have to get your Eidolon up to speed, which shouldn't take long, to be honest.
We have a month, so
I know. It is something that, you know, if you are around tomorrow, we can literally just do it tomorrow if you wanted to.
Okay, I got a bunch of family coming over for Easter and all.
Hey, it's like, what time they coming over?
Oh, they're coming over early.
Going over
like,
early.
I'm sure you'll be at like work or whatever you're doing tomorrow still.
It's Sunday tomorrow! It's Sunday tomorrow, I don't work on Sundays.
How am I supposed to know that, Aaron? This is the first time we've talked in like the longest time.
Yeah, to be fair, I have also got a new job in that time. I've actually got a full-time job now, so...
Nice.
I work at a call centre, it's shit.
Is it shitter than what you used to work at? Is the real question.
Oh wait, who do you work for? I want to call him up.
Fuck you. I work for...
I call up every day going, am I having a problem here?
I work for...
Mail, it didn't even help me
I yet. Work for FMG, Accident Management.
Dang, in the time I've been gone, Michael's been getting a lot more lippy.
Yeah.
Dang.
It's been some dark days since you've been gone.
I can tell.
Since you've been gone. Sorry. can I just say, on the video, people can see kind of what you're walking in against.
Oh, shit.
I ain't scared.
On the video, because I was just making sure things were set up before I started things up again, people can kind of see what you're going to be walking in against.
Oh, okay.
By the way, as soon as I see Fred Wu, I'm smiting evil on him.
That's fine.
Who's the strongest attacker in this group? With
Jonathan!
Me.
Jonathan!
Yeah, I guess I should probably get down from your back before you charge in, huh?
Yeah! I'm gonna sit on my shoulders and just shoot spells everywhere.
I could.
You might have to concentrate each spell more.
But, I'm ready for when we're there. I'll be right behind Andy. Jonathan.
Alright, is everyone back, by the way?
Yeah, I'm back.
Yeah. Actually, I wouldn't have to get any spell thing or spell whatever if I use spider walk on you, right? Or spider climb? It's kind of stuck to your back.
Take the extra weight.
I wouldn't. That's probably going to be more of a hindrance than a help for him. Alright, so to clear you off, are you going willingly with the guards?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I suppose.
Okay.
I've been watching this. screw off.
Are you just gonna be walking down the street like the fucking A Team? It's like, it's like.
Can I be Mr. T?
I'm really the fool.
I think Mr. T is a bit bigger.
Wow.
It'd be more Jonathan's role.
Oh, back at it again, Michael. Dashing hopes and dreams all over the place.
Sorry. You can get on his shoulder and pretend to be bigger then.
Yeah, oh, wait! You know the that one commercial where it's like Big Mr. T and Little Mr. T?
I don't know.
No.
I know. Don't look for it. We don't have time. Not really. Right. So, just continuing on. The guards escort you to the manor, and then they all stop outside and they go, "In you go. Good luck. You'll need it."
Thank you.
You mean you'll need it? Ha! Get memed.
Oh, I don't think they know what a meme is. I don't think they have them in this world.
Also, for anyone who's wondering, I'm just gonna put it in the group.
What the fuck? Oh, it's a military family thing. No one didn't see it. Right, okay, so you guys enter the manor. And there is, there are double doors open at the straight ahead, and you can see in the distance Fred Woo.
Evil, it's my evil.
What's the range of it?
I think it's just sight. Let me have a look.
Yeah, Buzzy, might want to check.
You would have thought that we would have been fighting within in the sight. Courtyard or something.
As long as I can see him.
Yeah, that's fine. Okay, yep, so you how long does Smite Evil last?
Till I kill him, or till the next day.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, is Marceline doing the same, or...?
Yes, I fucking am.
Okay. So he's kind of...
Wow,
watch
your language.
He just kind of looks at you, just kind of beckons you inside. You enter the room, and
is he on higher ground?
Yeah, currently he's standing like that, and he goes... The parties actually surprised you accepting my challenge. I thought you'd probably go run scared. Now, before you do anything foolish, you might not want to step forward just now. Just saying.
There's evil around the room.
Just evil. There's evil, like, directly, like, in front of you.
Holy shit.
I perceive the room.
You perceive the room. As you're perceiving the room, don't even bother rolling. As you perceive the room, he kind of makes a grand gesture with, like, both arms. You can, like, almost see, like, dark energy radiating from him, and he rises.
Oh, wow.
And he goes, no, don't worry. They're not here for you to fight you. They're here for me, and with that he kind of kneels over, puts one knee on the ground, slams both his hands down. All of these guys instantly just disappear again. Kind of just turn into a massive pile of bones, and he goes, "It's time for you to see what I'm actually capable of." And the room starts pulsating with just this dark negative energy, and all the bones just start racing towards Fred Wu, and almost forming like a new body. It's probably the best way I can describe it.
It's Gravelonito.
Okay, and you see him gradually start growing in size and turning it less of like a human but into like almost like a skeletal abomination.
It's quite big.
Yeah, I couldn't find a good sprite for it, so that's just what I was using. And as he goes, he goes, "Oh, I'm not done yet." And he rises his hands one last time, and 1 second.
We could break through the fucking building.
No, there's a very high roof on this. And you see, from that pillar down, and that down, walls arise. Actually, I've done that too much. You have to give me a tip. I have done that too much. Right, you see walls rise there, and right there, and he goes,
make it easier.
And he goes, well, welcome on there. Oh wait, no, sorry, I've got one last surprise for you. And you see his left arm starts like almost like mutating. The best way I could describe it is: has anyone played Resident Evil 4?
No.
Yes.
Right, for those who have, do you know Krauser? Yeah. That's the best way I can probably describe it. With that kind of arm on there. And that kind of like arms like seems like grow out and form not only like a giant blade, but like a shield, which he immediately brings in front of himself. And I want everyone to roll initiative.
While he was transforming, can I slap Andy with some full strength or whatever?
Yeah, go ahead.
Do I have to roll for it or anything?
No. You just do it. And if he's willing to take it, which I imagine he will be, he just gets it.
Sure, yeah.
There. Thank you. Some full strength. Plus four,
I'm gonna be last, but...
Well, it's not like we're going around you anyway. What is initiative?
Natural 20! It's a d20 plus your dex.
Are you fucking serious?
Oh, I get an extra 2. Mine's 13.
Okay.
No, not 13. 12. Yeah, 13.
Alright,
then. I do math.
Jonathan gets 4. Marceline gets 9. Mage gets 17. And Valden gets 13?
Yeah.
I'm assuming that Dan. Dan will go up for you, yeah. So, top of the round is that fella who doesn't move. He just stands there with his shield right in front of him and goes, come on then, you've got everything to lose.
Ooh, cocky little shit, huh?
We don't really have anything. We've got an entire city.
Midge.
I can't use mage armor on someone else, can I?
Yeah, you can.
I can?
Yes, it's shield that you can't, but you can only use on yourself or your Eidolon.
I'll use some mage armor on Andy, too.
Okay, cool. Andy, you got +4 AC.
Yay,
He's kind of slapped your back head. Keep in mind the number of spells that you've used, which I think that was a first. That's the first and a second you've used. Alright?
Can you pick multiple people?
No.
Oh.
Not with...
Only Willow do that.
Well, no, because Willow doesn't even do that. She just uses multiple castings.
Oh, does she? Oh,
yeah, she uses mobile casters just to kind of... She just kind of goes, okay, so I would have had, like, so many rounds to do it, one, and I'd have got, yeah. She's like, okay, cool. 1, 2, 3, I would have a mage arm on all them. Right, so, you can still move mage if you want, which I think would be 15 feet for you.
Yeah, I'm good. I'm trying to move.
All right, Dan.
I don't
want to
get to him right now.
Something that you hold my action for those guys to move up. Yeah, that's fine. Now what you can see, you've done something, I'm afraid. But what you can see is his shield arm being in front of him covers him up basically entirely. So it'll be extremely difficult to hit him with any kind of projectile at this point. And things like, you could also tell that things like magic missiles will not work. They'll just hit the shield and do nothing.
Excellent.
Yeah, sounds like my parents just got home. Hmm.
Is it my turn?
Yes.
Ooh, lost where I am. Okay, remove stuff from that. Move like 15 in front of that. And is there anything of his face like showing off any part of his body?
No, not really at all.
Is there any gaps near him?
What do you mean by any gaps?
Like to behind him.
What you mean like over here?
Sort of like, is there any gaps like for a shield? So there's some gaps like there.
Not particularly.
Anything like throw it, like over his hedge? Head?
On the roof? Technically, yeah. Above his head, yeah, there's some gap there.
Well, so like, does the shield like goes directly above his head up to the roof?
No, not straight up to the roof, no.
And I fire a fireball like directly above his head on the roof, so the fire encompasses
the roof. The roof is way higher up. The roof is like really high up, yeah.
How high is the roof?
Well, he is probably about at least 10 to 12 feet high at the moment. The roof is probably about 20 feet. It's probably, I don't know.
Could you reach the roof if you wanted to?
Actually, would a fireball... Actually, no. If you aim a fireball directly above him, it might just get him, actually.
Because it has a 20-foot radius.
Yes. Yeah, it would actually just get him then. Sorry. Roof isn't that big. So I have to make a reflex now, don't I?
Yes. And then you take half damage.
Mm-hmm.
I cast a little again.
Do you want to roll damage?
7.
I can't even see what you guys are rolling right now.
I mean, I did a GM roll for my save.
Really? 2? Wait, 3 wait, ones?
Wait, what the heck? Wait, hang on. 76 plus 2? How's it plus 2?
Oh. It's not plus 2, but that was from my initiative that I forgot to
change. Oh, okay. So it's 76, so it's 20.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, as you do it, it hits above him, and he just kind of seems to be kind of standing there. He actually looked to him like the fireball was going to come kind of directly at him, but you somehow managed to manipulate it to launch it up in the air and hit the ceiling. He was not expecting that. And so he does not manage to dodge away in time and takes a chunk of damage.
Get fucked, faggot!
Because, okay, Marceline.
So, his shield thing, is that metal?
It looks like kind of flesh and bone and metal and all sorts just kind of mixed together.
Is it like a part of his arm?
Yes. The shield is basically his arm, but it's also a bladed weapon. Again, think Krauser from Resident Evil 4, if you know him. That would be a good comparison.
But there's metal in it.
Yeah, a bit, yeah.
Right. So, you know, step forward. With my shield out, just get in the way. And then use Burning Disarm.
That was the thing from Prototype.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wait.
Burning Disarm.
Wait. It's like all the plus. I can't get all the way there. Never mind.
Alright.
Yeah, not close enough. So I'm just gonna stand in the fucking way.
Okay. Jonathan.
Andy, what his last name so happened to be Joester?
No. Talking about
caught.
I'm gonna do Divine Bond.
What does that do?
It makes my weapon plus 1. Well, it makes it plus 2 now.
Okay.
For 7 minutes. I'm gonna move.
Wait,
is that it?
Wait, can I just check something just real quick? Sorry.
It's a standard action.
No. I just want to check something about it.
Okay. But it increases the enhancement.
Oh, is it a paladin actual thing? Right.
Yeah.
Okay, 1 second.
Is either that or the mount?
No. But what I want to check is, does it stack?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's fine. Yep. Go ahead.
And yeah, I've moved. And that's all I can do.
Okay. Okay, so... Yep.
Is this area open over there?
Yeah, it looks to be.
Look, I could take a shot at him. So I was going to try moving around over there.
There's a wall there, isn't there?
That's what I was asking.
No, but there's stairs.
There's stairs over there.
Yeah, right here.
Yeah, and over there.
Alright, just be careful if you're thinking about doing that.
I don't want to, though. I don't
like, know can you I shoot am. Over these walls? These purple walls?
No, no.
I can't even move that far anyway,
Those walls, the walls themselves, do actually go straight up to the ceiling. But with the fireball, he was able to hit the ceiling above him and do damage.
I was just making sure.
I'll be there this turn. I don't think I can shoot him. No.
Okay, he's actually going to rush forward and do a charge on Marceline.
Oh, shit.
What's my plus? Right.
You should have buffed the tank.
I thought you were the tank.
No, I'm 30. The damage dealer.
Oh.
Damn, dude.
Oh fuck, it would have hit me anyway.
Right.
Holy shit, it gets a plus 13?
This is actually something that I made of myself.
Was not prepared.
Oh wow, 12 points of damage.
Don't worry, I've got this.
Oh no, 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 make that 14 so I can see charged.
Alright.
What? Because
well, he charged.
He gets plus 2.
Yeah.
But now he's on a minus 2 AC.
Yep, yep. And... One second.
Hmm.
And you, I want you to make me a reflex save, please. I'm having to talk quieter now because okay. You get pushed back 10 feet, but you manage to stay on your feet from the sheer just force of the blow. Now it's Midge.
I only move 20 feet, right? Right?
I think it's a bit less because you're encumbered.
Turn. Can I move 15 feet?
I think it's about 15, isn't it?
I don't know.
Yeah, go ahead.
Right. Damn it.
Right.
Well, I can cast something behind him, correct?
No, because from this position, because of his shield, you can't see directly behind him.
There's no cracks at all that I can see through?
No. That's kind of the point of what he's done.
Fine. I want to use a level 3 summoning spell.
Alright, so what are you summoning?
I don't have to roll for it. This is the first time I've ever summoned something that wasn't by accident. Let's see. Oh, can you summon a monster?
You don't need to roll for summoning. You just summon, don't you?
Right, well,
beneath the same kind. Wait, right. I don't understand how this works, if I'm being completely honest.
Right, one second, let me have a look.
Here, I got ya, for the link.
Right, basically, with summon monster, you can summon a monster up to one of those threes.
Uh,
Yeah, so essentially, from Summon Monster 1 through to 3, you get those. You can summon any one of those. So essentially, just pick one that you want. You can't have the Dretch, I'm going to say, or the Hellhound. Anything that's evil, I'm going to say you cannot have. So essentially, you just pick one that you want. No, we can't hear you, Dakota.
What? How did my mic get muted? That is so weird.
It seems to keep happening.
So wait, I can pick three monsters from the table, no. Or I get to pick one from the first three, like, the one. First three monsters on the table?
No, you pick one, and it can either be from Summon Monster 1, Summon Monster 2, or Summon Monster 3. Summon Monster 3 is... You can either summon one creature from third, 1d3 of the same kind from second, or 1d4 plus one from first.
What about those summon monsters or alternative summoning options?
I don't see any reason why you couldn't. Again, obviously like a bloody human skeleton, not summoning that.
Dang, dude, all these things kinda fucking suck. At least the ones I've been looking at. I'm gonna summon a werebore? Or a dire boar?
A dire boar. What one does that come from?
It's the
there it
summon
is.
Monsters 3 alternative summoning option.
Okay, cool. So
I'm gonna summon it, let's see, one. I'm gonna summon it right here.
Okay, 1 second.
It can run 40. I want it to run all the way over here.
Alright, 1 second.
I'm assuming it can fit through here, right?
Right, I've put it under your control. So if you want to move it, go ahead. Have you got the thingy sheet open for it?
Yeah, I was looking at it. It can move 40 feet.
Alright, cool. So I'll just leave it there for now. Right. You do still technically have your movement, so...
I already used it.
Oh, you should.
I can't move far.
Okay, so, Dan.
Oh, I still can't shoot this fucking guy. I run all the way around there, he might be dead before I even get there.
Making double move, I get 60.
Oh, yeah. That's his boar thing. Where is that? He friendly to me?
Yes.
Well, I mean, he's under the control. Wow. I was asking Dakota, really.
Yeah, he's friendly enough.
I suppose I'll just run up there with his thing.
Oh, dang, I should have got on my boar. That way I could have got behind him. Damn it. Such good ideas now.
Okay, so that's Dan Valden.
Would I be able to blade dash through him?
Hang on.
It says on the spell, doesn't it?
It just says when you cast a spell, you immediately move up to 30 feet in a straight line, any direction, momentarily leaving a multi-hued cascade of images behind you. This movement does not provoke attack opportunities. You may make a single attack melee of your highest base attack bonus against any one creature you are adjacent to any point. It doesn't say about like any big creatures or all of that.
I think you could, but it's what, 30 feet?
Oh yeah, I can move first, then cast it.
Oh, okay, so you like move there and then you got kind of go, so you move like there, yeah, and then go like 30 feet like over there, like I could. I think you technically can. I don't see any reason why you couldn't.
Aaron, I'm just saying, does that mean we have to add the 5d8 plus 20 health?
No.
To the board plus the 42?
No. The 42 is from the 5d8 plus 20.
Oh, I was about to say, holy crap, that would be broken.
I'm moving there, then casting Blade Dash.
But is it just like damage, or do you roll an attack on the way past?
Oh, no, it's... I roll attack on the way past, yeah. Right. I just thought you so.
Alright. So... Right, go ahead.
It's good. Is it going to get a second sense bonus? Blade Dash, sure, I may... on your attack roll, equal to your intelligence. Fire.
Nice.
What's my base attack?
It's...
No, I'm looking for it now.
Yeah. I can't remember what it is for Magus. Wow, 27. Anything
you crit? Does that count as a crit?
Anything you crit? I think it's in your crit range as well. Here's what I'm thinking. Sorry, hang on. I'm trying to think. Would the hit technically kind of be on the way past? So it'd be kind of like, you kind of like, you know, you potentially like...
It's like swinging as I'm moving forward.
Yeah,
so like,
yeah,
at the point of me passing him would be like the swinging point.
But you say, so essentially you start there, you kind of gone there, and then as you're kind of like moving through him, you do the swing like there, and then continue on.
And have like a cool finishing pose at the end.
Okay, sure. So Varden does that. That's between his legs. Does somehow finds his way through his shield. Unfortunately, the swing has hit the shield and has just been deflected off. That does not hit.
It doesn't mean something like 1d6 anyway.
that didn't hit, I'm afraid.
Doesn't hit.
Marceline.
I see what he's fucking doing. That's what he said, was he's gonna regret it. God damn it. Fuck you, Aaron.
Wait, what?
You said we were gonna regret it, you're gonna piss us off. This is what the pissing us off bit is. The fucking shield. God damn it. Can you hit a shield so hard it just fucking goes through?
Maybe, you don't know.
I'm gonna fucking try.
Well, it's Mad Sleeve's turn first.
Yeah, I know.
Was the edge of him? Is it like, is the edge of him like here or whatever?
Yes.
Alright, cool.
Yeah, he's a 15 by 15 thing.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, technically 10 by, he's 10 by 10 technically, but 15 across.
Alright, I just lunge and stab at the fucking thing in front of me.
Are you charging him?
No.
I'm surprised. You get your smite evil bonus, don't you?
Yep, which is, I had my charisma bonus to this.
Which is big. Wow.
So I'll be 16.
That misses.
Yeah.
Or rather, he just hits and just completely glances off his shield. Jonathan.
I've been waiting for this all week, and it's gonna give me a 1. I can fucking sense it.
What?
And just because, fuck it, get the high numbers higher, let's fucking charge.
Remember you're plus 4.
Yeah, I know, I've got it all set up, ready to go.
Wait, wait, it's plus 2 for strength.
Get fucked. Does it go through the shield?
That definitely hit.
That definitely
does good contact. Do you wanna roll for damage?
Yeah, sure, give me a sec. I wasn't prepared. Where is it? I think I got this.
Jesus Christ.
So it is... Shit. I didn't calculate a single hit. One sec, give me a sec.
Well, the ball strength gives you an additional +2 to your strength for damage and to
hit. Yeah, but I've got Smite Evil, and that's 2 times, so it's 14 plus 15.
29. You charge, okay. So you get another 2.
Oh, Jesus, it's 31. Okay, so it's...
You might have made him... Wow, 37. Okay. Jonathan yells out a mighty ferocious battle cry and charges at Fred Wu. Slicing down, Fred Wu has a pretty smug look on his face and kinda like puts his shield out and you can see his face visibly kinda like, you know, look a bit panicked as Jonathan's mighty blow cleaves into part of the shield. It does not connect with Fred Wu, however, the actual shield arm itself looks like it's taking a bit of damage.
Only a bit?
Yes.
I thought that bitch would have been snapped in half.
It is a giant shield.
That's a lot of damage.
But it's done no damage to him.
It's done no damage to him. Shield. He turns his attention to you, Jonathan, and he's going to swing at you with his kind of bladed shielded arm.
Okay. Alrighty.
Right. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Alright. I'm on 25.
And he does 17 points of damage, and then I want you to make a reflex save. Yeah, it's fine. You get pushed back 10 feet, but you still remain in your feet. Hey, it means you can charge again. Midge and Boar technically as well.
I don't know what the Boar's stats would be for jumping, so I guess they gotta walk around this thing.
It's not too far up. It's like 5 feet up. It could jump off.
It's only 4 stairs, if you're able to get up there.
Yeah, it's fine. The very disfigured Boar.
Oh yeah, on this turn I tell Adam's character to make way for the Boar. Also, it's about yonder.
Right, it could probably get to about there, because remember, that is a pillar.
Okay.
That is a pillar, so it would get to about there. And kind of just keep kind of like by the throne, so to speak.
And my character is gonna walk over. Yay. Do you think I could reach Marceline?
With
a touch?
No, you gotta be standing right next to them.
God damn it. Okay, well that ruins that plan. I mean, if I would have thrown my bag on the ground back there, then I could. Can I do that, or can I not do that and cast?
If you want, as part of your movement, to kind of drop your bag of holding, then yes, that's fine. You can move that extra 5 feet.
Okay, I'm gonna slap her with a, what the hell is it called?
Mage Armor.
Yeah, Mage Armor. So you have plus 40 AC.
Also, Marceline, are you using your shield, or...?
Yeah.
Right. Okay, so that's Midge. Dan.
I'm gonna go and climb up this wall. What do I need for climbing?
That's fine, just walk up. It's like 5 feet. That's fine. So that's 20 feet. Then, I don't know, then like 25, and now the ball's in the way.
Alright, can I move? I might as well use extra one. I'll move around there.
Right.
Next turn I can move forward and shoot him.
Okay. Valden.
You probably could have sight right there, unless he's a double movement.
To be honest, you could move a bit more down if you wanted. So that was like 25.
Is he not in the 30, way?
35. Not really. 40, 45, 50.
Because this is three 60. Wide and the board is only two wide.
Yeah, you can get about there. Yeah. That's fine.
I don't know if I could get there. Cause I'm not sure where this wall was supposed to be because they're kind of.
I did it by grid. I survived him.
Was that next to him, or was I already next to him?
You were there.
Cough, remember to move somewhere out of the way a little bit so the boar can get by. He's a big-ass creature.
There, so.
Right.
I can pull my weapon, go for a strike plus a spell, bind with it, force punch.
You're doing force punch with it.
Yeah.
I don't think you'll be able to move him, but that's fine.
I don't. It's just a little damage.
Alright, fair enough, go ahead. That hits.
Yes! I'll do the normal hit.
Alright.
Oh, wow.
Take some damage.
And now force punch.
Okay.
Oh.
Wow, that wasn't good. But yeah, okay, so as following kind of the suggestion from Mage to move to the side a bit, you step to the side and then you focus your spell through your weapon and stab him in the back. You were expecting actually a lot more resistance, but actually stabbing him in the back, you seem to not really get any resistance. And it looks like it's done some damage. Marceline.
I'll just stab again. Try and hit anything. Twenty-four,
that misses, I'm afraid. That back deflects off his shield again.
Yeah.
Anything else?
What, on me?
Yeah.
I'll slap myself.
You... Oh, okay. Jonathan. Yes, you can charge again. That's fine. Is that a hit? That hits. Oh, damage. Has Andy just gone quiet?
Oh, my mic's in. Damage has been reduced now, hasn't it? Yeah.
Yeah. Because you don't get the double now for piling level. But you still get your charge bonus.
Yeah. So
get the full strength too, bud.
Yeah, I know. I still do decent-ish.
30, okay.
Damn.
How's that shield looking?
Once again, the shield seems to absorb the blow, but again, you've taken another kind of bit of a chunk out of it. Top of the round with him, he starts looking increasingly worried, and he's going to,
He's gonna teleport, isn't he? Like, old
nope,
bitch.
Nope. He is going to do a essentially like a cleave on everyone adjacent to him.
Oh fuck.
starting
even
with
behind him.
Starting with Jonathan.
Uh-huh. Oh yep. That hit.
doing 11 damage to Jonathan. And then Jonathan, can you please
roll me? You fucking serious?
Can you please roll me reflex as he
bullshit. Where is it?
Yep, stay on your feet, but you get knocked back. Marceline.
I just want to set up.
I need to hit.
13 damage to Marceline, and you roll me a reflex. And can I also have Mitch roll reflex as well, please, as well? Right, no, you're gonna...
Yeah, give me a minute.
Yeah, I'm afraid you're gonna be knocked prone, Marceline.
Mm-hmm.
So... Okay, it was a d20, right?
Yep.
That's not my d20.
Yeah, I'm afraid that Midge gets hit by Marceline as she goes flying past, taking 5 points of damage. And also gets knocked prone.
Wouldn't that some shit?
And then finally, Valden.
I can't do damage, by the way.
He's done a swing and just kind of gone all the way around.
All the way around, but he's surrounded by walls. How can
he is surrounded by walls.
Because as he does it, and you're gonna have to give me a moment, he actually destroys part of this wall.
And just goes through it. Holy
yep.
shit!
Bitch ass walls.
Yep, there's now a chunk of the wall off to his left that isn't covered. But I've hit you, Valden, and I am doing 17 points of damage. And can you make me a reflex save, please?
Sorry.
By the way, Aaron, I can't mess with my health, so you're gonna have to do it.
What? Can you not do it?
I know. If I click on my health, it doesn't let me do it.
Okay, do it now.
There you go. Thank you.
Nope, so you get sent. Yep, you also get knocked prone.
That was something,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, shit.
Right, okay, 1 second, sorry. I'm just going to quickly just...
Oh, wait, it's just on his turn. Oh, thank Christ.
Does summoning a level 3 monster count towards my level 2 and 1 spells, or no?
What do you mean, your summon monster thing?
Yeah.
No, because it's just something that you can do as a summoner.
That's pretty sweet.
Okie dokie.
Right,
I'm assuming I can't summon more than one level 3 thing a day, though, right?
What? With some monster?
Yeah.
I don't know if you can have more than one of them out at a time, but you can do it as many times as you've got the ability to do it.
Hmm. Well, what that means... Probably summoning a level 2 monster. I'm assuming Venom wouldn't work on a,
He made a clone! Dead.
Probably not.
Oh, what happened?
Army of midgets.
No, I was just changing something. Right, so that's that. Midge the Midge, it will take your movement to stand up.
Okay. Before anything, I want this boar to charge.
Okay, that's
this
fine.
Douchebag. But I'm not sure, on his offense, it says melee gore plus 8, melee 2d 6 plus 9,
mm-hmm.
But I don't know...
The plus 8 is what he rolls
to
hit.
Is for the attack?
And
okay.
Then the 2d's, although, because he's charged, he'll get an additional plus 2, so it'll actually be plus 10. 10, yeah.
Dang, probably didn't hit.
No, that hit.
Oh, sweet. And it's the... Do I get any bonuses to the damage?
You will get an additional plus 2 to the damage because you're charged. So it will actually be a 2d6 plus 11. 14.
Dang.
14 damage, as he seems to be just completely tackled from behind by this giant boar.
After Midge gets up, he's gonna... Ah, I was gonna summon a reef claw, but I don't think they can walk on land, so...
Hang on, sorry. I just wanna know, can it...
I'm gonna summon...
Wait, no. The effect is one summoned creature? I'm going to assume that you can only summon one creature summoned at a time.
Hmm.
At least for now, until I know otherwise.
Okie dokie, then. Well, then I'm going to use my action to get Marceline up.
Is that a thing you can do? You know what? I want you to make me a... strength check to see if you can kind of hoist her up, because she is in heavy armor.
No, I cannot.
Unfortunately, Midge, you do not manage to hoist Marceline up. So, Dan.
Can I shoot over this guy?
Yeah,
I'm on the floor.
He's lying down on the floor.
Small.
Even if he wasn't, the thing's ginormous, so you're probably pretty safe.
I was specifically aiming for his foot. I'm not, Aaron. I'm not. Don't use that against me.
I don't see why not with your gun.
You shoot his arm off.
That hits.
Shocker. Ew. Fucking Mike.
My name is Dan.
Nine damage as he gets hit from behind by a gun. Valden.
He's stunned.
Okay.
And then I cast Flaming Sphere on the guy.
Okay. This is reflex gonna be shit.
Flaming Sphere is now a box.
Rectangle. It looks like Charger Barrier that's really empty.
I passed, I got 18.
Oh my god.
What? I got 18. Marceline.
Which way is he facing us, right?
He's facing you, yeah. You're on the floor though at the moment.
Yeah, I'm gonna stand up.
Mm-hmm.
Lay on hands and then.
Mm-hmm.
And then. Alright, that was. Standing up, there's. What kind of action?
Boo.
Marking movement.
Your movement.
The entirety of your movement.
Yeah.
God bless you.
Thank you. What? Be me or Marcelina?
Marcelina, of course. It cares about you.
Dang! Mike's just being a savage.
And then, you fucking, I'm gonna cast Burning Disarm on him.
I was talking about the Game Master there. The Game Master I hate, but Aaron, he is my friend, I like him. But when he's the Game Master, he's so annoying.
Oh, thanks, you dick.
You do go out of your way to screw us.
I'm making it challenging.
So you say.
I'm just joking.
I don't want to hear it, he's gonna... Boring. Big ass fucking board in front of him that's unbreakable. Unless
I mean,
Andy
Jonathan's
hits him.
Getting through it.
Right. Yeah. Okay. Alright, what does Burning Disarm do?
Alright, heats up the weather thing. I'm doing it on his shield arm, whatever, because he's got metal in it. Becomes red hot. Creature holding the item may attempt to reflex save to drop it and take no damage. Otherwise, the hot metal deals 1d4 points of fire damage per caster level, maximum of 5d4. Circumstances that prevent the creature from dropping the item mean that the creature gets no saving throw.
Okay, so just roll the damage.
Fucking wrecked! Part of his arm.
Yeah, you can't drop it.
Because it's like a cleric spell, what's my caster level for this?
What is this? An oracle thing, or...?
Well, I pull my spells from the same list, so...
I'd assume that you could have the max 5 then.
Sod. Because it's paladins and oracles get from the cleric list, so it's just, you know, whatever. So, 5, 4. I don't think there's any pluses on this, is there?
Probably not, no.
Okay. 9.
I keep forgetting, is it rounded up or rounded down if it's halves?
Usually you round it down.
Right, okay. So, it does seem to burn him a bit, but not as much as it normally would. You would guess it's because of all the flesh of the bone kind of like around the metal, that it's not quite as effective as it should be.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, it's just a bit of flesh and bone burning.
Yep. Jonathan!
Is there any way to anchor myself to the ground?
Not particularly.
So we'll get pushed back.
You're getting a horse stance. Fucking weeb style.
Then you get punted.
I hate being fucking pushed back every time. I can't do my shit.
What is it, just because you're a big man? You just gotta not get hit.
Oh, that's a good point, yeah. But he's already gonna hit me AC anyway, fuck it. This time I'm not gonna charge.
Really?
Yeah, because that'll get me plus 280. It's going to save me this round.
That is a good point.
I only do plus 20, though, so this is...
never mind. Oh, only. Yeah, you hit. points.
The fucking shield gone yet. That's like 90 damage.
okay. Now. First of all, the Game Master will put his headset back on after yanking it off his head. Second of all, what happens now, what's just happened is, once again, you've swung, once again you've hit his shield, but this time you've hit it took such a beating from you already, and you've hit it with such force that it's gone straight through into him himself, and he takes the full brunt of this damage.
Oh, that's not fair!
So close.
Looks like Dakota and his boar swoop in for the kill.
Okay. Fred Wu is going to Fred Wu is going to, like, you see his arm and it starts to suddenly mutate again. But this time, the shield disappears from his arm, and that mutation spreads throughout his entire body.
Oh.
He looks a lot more armored now than he did before.
Son of a bitch.
But that was his action, that's all he could do.
Sorry.
So, Midge.
Maybe the ball won't get the last hit.
Maybe not. I want to do an acid splash.
You've got to roll to hit in a ranged touch, isn't it?
Yes.
So it's basically a ranged attack, but you hit on touch, you see?
Oh, shit.
Yeah, you fire a small orb of acid at the target. You must succeed on a ranged touch hit.
Yeah. On a ranged touch attack, so...
What the hell is a ranged touch attack? Just wondering.
Basically, it's a ranged attack, which means it's d20 plus 7, but you hit on their touch AC.
Which is most of the time just their dex.
Nine.
It's like, I haven't rolled anything but a 2 this entire time when I've been doing something.
I mean, didn't you roll a 20 earlier in the day?
Oh, yeah, I did, for perception. I saw the shit out of that door.
I mean...
Midge,
well, you're right.
Midge, guys, Midge,
yeah.
How do you want to end this?
With an acid splash?
No. Basically, what I'm saying is, I want you to describe how your acid splash, this puny little spell, somehow beats this seemingly unstoppable foe.
He's sitting over there, opening his mouth, laughing away, thinking he's some tough shit with this armor, and I just get him right in the mouth, burn his insides out.
Okay, so as Fred Wu finishes his mutation and then starts cackling with mad glee, "Ah, you will never beat me! This is now everywhere!" For Midge, seeing the opportunity, fires an acid splash into his mouth, completely bypassing the armor that he's just put over his entire body and burning his insides. And Fred Wu just falls over.
I'm assuming he only has one health left, right?
Yeah, he only had one health left. Which is why I didn't have to roll for damage. Okay, so
I'm digging through all the fucking corpses and getting his corpse.
So well, what you find is, as you go over, he's not dead.
What?
He's actually still alive, but he's like coughing up blood. He's coughing up black blood. He's like,
can I destroy him right now?
Yeah, can I just get the boar to do a little fucking dance on his face?
Hold up, stop. As you guys start walking towards Fred Wu,
Nah, mate, he's not getting the fucking way. Nah, fuck off. Attack of opportunity, mate. Come on.
Yeah, this is actually my turn still, so the
he's
letting him finish.
A purple door shows up. Appears.
No, I can fuck him right now. I'll fuck the necromancer right now.
And out steps his necromancer, and he just goes, and I'm afraid we've seen that. It starts that's cackling once again. It's like, now I'll be granted even greater power. Fred Moore is like lying right in front of him, and he just goes, and the Link Master kind of just gets on one knee, puts his hands on Fred Moore, and goes, "Your services are no longer required." Then energy pulsates into Fred Wu, and Fred Wu's body just instantly disintegrates. And the necromancer seems to absorb Fred Wu's essence, and he goes, "Ah, to feel whole again."
He's measuring the distance.
If you want to do it, you can do it.
Don't fucking tempt me.
I mean, you remember what happened? This is the guy that...
Smite evil,
that Ryan. But, and he just looks at Jonathan, like, preparing to charge, and he goes, "If you think you can hit me, then come hit me."
Nobody's fired magic missiles, dude.
What, sorry?
Magic missiles, somebody said that.
Smite evil, go!
The magic missiles that you fire, Valden, kind of seem to just deflect off him. Kind of like they did in that cave, if you remember.
Wait, let me... Yes, swift action. Yeah. It's my go.
Okay, as you run forward, you instantly just slam against a wall of magical energy and get forced back. And he just goes...
What about a boar charge? God damn it, I was really hoping for a 20, yep. But I got a 2!
Yep. Well, the boar charges in, and the same thing happens.
Let me spear right on top of him.
Deflected away.
Should we try another acid ball?
Nope, force back.
What?
And he just goes, "Seriously, guys, this isn't going to work.
Fine.
The only one of you who's been able
no.
The only one of you has been able to damage me is not here. I could finish you all if I want. But where's the fun?
No, you fucking can't.
I'm gonna do a touch AC attack? Is this touch AC higher than that with an acid ball?
Deflected away.
This is some shit.
Slam a great start on it.
Stop. Can people just hold on a second, please, while you just pull up this list of spells?
I can bring myself back from the dead, so I'm good.
Glad to know you're thinking for the rest of us.
Prepared.
Can he not just then kill you again? How many times can you...
Twice?
Twice. So you think he's gonna get bored after the second resurrection? Just let you live after that.
One second.
Use a fire.
Okay, so he starts channeling a lot of energy into his hand, and he launches a fireball in Jonathan's direction. I want... No, get back there. I want everyone but Dan to roll me reflex. Valden gets hit, Midge gets hit, Jonathan gets hit, and Marceline... Ooh.
Well, I assume I'm gonna...
Hang on, what's my DC? Also gets it.
Let me check the boar. Don't worry.
Okay. However, this one came up with you such force. You take, and I'm not kidding here, and I'm not kidding, technically, and you did ask for this, I might add, you take 60 points of damage, just all of you instantly. Except Dan.
Well, I might as well fucking use my...
However, you don't die, you just get knocked out. And Dan is left there standing on his own. The boar does die though, I'm afraid, but all of you guys drop to...
Bring me below zero?
The rest of you drop to zero.
Then I'll bring myself back. With 10 health.
Okay, so as Jonathan looks like he's about to drop to the ground, he managed to catch himself and keep himself up. Meanwhile, everyone else drops to zero, and Jonathan is barely standing, and Mike, and so is... And Dan is just stood there, just outside the edge of the blast. And that's if it's... And yeah, it's 20-foot radius, yeah. So, and so the village goes, "Did you like that, big one? Don't do this again. You should be..."
Only a robot tries behind the shield.
Just because... Just because... just because you're not powerful enough to get through my shield doesn't mean that, you know, I'm a coward. I'm standing here right now, I've just fought you, what's your problem?
Mm.
And he goes, I'll be back later. I would kill you now, but part of me wants you to see my ultimate plan come to fruition, and then in your deepest moment of despair, that's when I'll kill you. Oh, I'll see you there. Oh, it'll be so nice. I'll see you then, big boy. Boy,
and I'll stomp on your corpse.
You can try. You can try. And he dimension doors his way out.
Aaron?
Yep.
Did you roll that fireball or not?
No.
Oh.
No. On his spell list is maximized fireball, which is technically 6th level, which basically means the fireball does maximum damage.
Son of a...
Which is 60. Are you healing people, Jonathan?
Yeah, I'll settle Steve.
Alright, so 14 to Marceline, 13 to Midge.
I'll gather with everybody.
You guys awake a big smoking crater.
I'm gonna go look on the skeleton for some powerful goodies.
Then.
Did you roll, John?
Yeah. Then you see a dimension door pop up again. He walks back through. This time he's carrying a very large chest, and he goes, "I suppose that if I want to make this fun, I better give you this. You know, as a congratulations for getting rid of a nuisance for me. Enjoy." Don't worry, it's not cursed, I promise. And he dimension doors away.
Well, that's a trustworthy individual, let me go open it.
Okay, you look inside and there is a lot of gold.
Oh, sweet. Cursed gold, guys! Hey, wow! I'm gonna go pick up my bag, by the way, Aaron.
Okay.
I need people around. It's like a fucking burst energy everywhere.
Yeah, everyone. Help me, Jonathan.
Everyone heals 21 points up to the maximum.
And that's... I'm out, I think. Yeah. Oh, got one left.
So what, do it on yourself?
Yeah, looks that way.
Jonathan. You only... You typed 21, not plus 21.
Did I? Oh, damn.
Yeah, one second. So, plus 10 you said you were on. There you are. Now do the final healing.
Yay.
Marceline technically has healed herself.
She was a little dazed. She's got blown up.
That was my fault.
yes. No one's disputing this.
Okay, so. Are you counting? Are you counting what's in the chest?
Yeah, we're counting.
Right. So after counting what's in the chest, you count a grand total of 14,000 gold pieces, which, let's be honest, split between all seven of you. So it's 2,000 each.
Who's the seventh? Oh, Ryan. Right, yes. Okay. I mean, yeah, Ryan, my favourite person.
Right. So, honestly, searching Fred Boo's body doesn't get you anything. And his body's been disintegrated anyway, so...
Other than covered in skeleton bones, then whatever crap was in there.
It's been completely disintegrated. It's no longer there.
Not such a room for anything.
But
we've got free reign under castle now.
I mean, it's still full of guards, I'm guessing.
Oh, we can kill them.
They're still outside.
Yeah, there's all those homos out there waiting for us. You're probably like, yeah, I bet we just took care of them. You hear that blast? Heard there.
I just walked past them and go, thanks for the luck, guys.
Speak of the devil. As you're saying that, a bunch of guards run in and they go, "What just happened?" They just see like this big like smoking crater that you guys are pretty much standing in. They just go, "What the fuck just happened here?"
You wanna fight?
Wait, whoa! I just wanna know what happened.
All that big shot and bullshit talk earlier, and you here to talk now?
We happened, is what happened, yeah.
Mitch Power!
Well, I don't know. I mean, a lot of you look pretty beat up to me.
I mean, I think
Fred looks dead to me, so.
He goes, okay. So, why don't you explain to us what the fuck you were doing?
Hold on, pause. What do you mean, what we were doing? You knew exactly what the hell we came here for. Asking dumbass questions.
Okay, let me rephrase it then. Why were you doing it? And where is Lord Wu now?
Pile of bone ash? Yeah. These broken walls, that was a lot of him.
He was a skelly man.
A what?
Skelly man.
A skelly man.
A skelly man. Do you have any proof?
I mean,
does that look like a regular corpse to you?
There is no corpse.
That was a pile of shit.
No, freaking disintegrated.
Yeah, this is like a pile of whatever.
There's a power of
from
power,
above.
Yeah. There's a power
oh, just making sure we do add 2,000 gold, correct?
Pardon?
We are all adding 2,000 gold, right?
Yeah.
Okay, sweet. Throwing that in my bag. Should I just, like, summon a boar to get rid of these fellas? Or what are we planning on doing with them?
Well, let's see if they're violent for us. That's not just
yeah. See if they want to be violent.
Are they evil? Did you do your evil thing?
They were being the retainers of Wu, so that kind of means they're evil.
I don't think
well, maybe they were just. Guards, maybe they had no. Look, let's just find out, dude. Alright. Okay.
Yeah, we'll just.
Look, give me a Fred Wu's dead. Alright, we killed him.
Can't you just detect evil on him there, paladin boy?
Detecting it. Are they evil?
You don't detect any evil from him.
It's all good.
Right. You good. Okay. So, you're saying that Lord Frederick Wu was a skeleton.
Did y'all not know that he was like the retainer to some dumbass necromancer?
No, we did not.
Damn, y'all are some badass guards, like, totally oblivious to the entirety of what's going on in your own city.
Oh, I'm sorry, he looked like a human whenever I saw him, whenever anyone saw him.
Big ass skeleton. Before that, he looked like a skeleton in a robe.
Right, me and Jonathan here.
No, hang on, sorry. Dakota, he looked human. Before he grew, he looked human.
His little character icon definitely looked like something was fucked up with his face.
He was wearing a cape.
You could still see his little fucking weird skeleton pimples.
Okay. Now, what were you saying, Marceline?
Me and Jonathan here, we're paladins. We can detect evil. Just like, you know, like, for instance, we can detect you guys being evil. Fred Wu, evil. And I
persuade them in some way.
Can you make me a diplomacy check, please?
Can do that. After casting on myself enhanced diplomacy.
And what does that do?
Gives me like a plus of like fuck all to my.
A plus fuck all.
Yeah, it's not a whole lot. Give me a minute.
It counts.
Enhance. What the fuck is it?
And while this is happening, I get on Jonathan's shoulders.
I get like a plus two to my whatever. So I get.
They kind of look at each other, and then they look back at you, and they go, "So you and the big guy are paladins."
I've got a holy book, and I pull out my book, my prayer book, and I start reading shit from it.
We like.
He goes. Can you just hold on a second? And he kind of beckons to someone, kind of in the room, and in walks a cleric.
Wow. Notice this evil asshole the entire time.
And he just goes, can you just go check that book and just see if they're legit? They're claiming that they're paladins. And he goes, okay. So the cleric walks over to you, Marceline, and he goes, may I see your holy book and your holy symbol?
Yes, you may.
And what makes you a paladin? I'm assuming your order has something like that?
God looks down upon me and smiles, obviously.
Well, may I see your holy symbol and your holy book then, please?
Yes.
We say that your holy symbol is basically a symbol of your order. I'm assuming.
I hope it doesn't look at my holy symbol.
He kind of looks at me and he goes, well, this one seems real. He seems true. What about that one?
Well, I've got the book and...
No, the other one.
Jonathan.
You can't trust this obvious holy paladin and his word, cleric?
By the way, hope my holy symbol is actually a shuriken that's got blood on it. So, I pass it to him.
He's slightly more standard, Jonathan.
He looks at it and he goes... You see his eyes widen as he sees it and he goes... Yep, these guys are real. I'm not messing with them. The order of that one in the back is actually probably the most honorable order around. Just saying.
Huh. He knows about me.
right. And the guys go, what do you mean? And so the cleric then explains to them about Jonathan's order and the kind of how they only punish those who properly deserve it. So if they've gone after Fred Wu, he must have done something to deserve it. We apologize then for what we've said. Honest question, what should we do now?
What did you ask us for?
Well, you are clearly mighty adventurers. You probably have more knowledge than any of us will ever have in regards such as this.
I mean, I don't think any of us have.
Let me do a knowledge history on the history of skeleton men taking over counties or whatever. Hold on. Sorry. None comes to mind of this situation exactly, especially with. The whole, us saving it and all. is this the head kingdom right now, or are they a vassal to somebody? What's going on?
I'm just going to take you back to the main screen. Nation, so to speak, is basically a collaboration of these various villages and fortresses and towns and such, who can band together, and they are known as the city-states of Valinor. They have a city-state of Valinor. They form the Valinor League, so to speak, and the main one is Valengard. That's where the centre of it is, but you know that other than that, Havergast and Union City are the two biggest ones after that, in that order. Actually, no, sorry, probably in the other order.
Who is it here in charge before Wu?
Someone who's now dead.
Did he have any descendants left?
Not that they were aware of, huh?
I don't know, looks like you might be a little shit out of luck. I want to find the new king, or whatever you want to call him.
Right. Okay. We'll figure something out. Anyway, please feel free to stay in town for as long as you require before moving on.
I think you need to find the minister of giving out rewards for saving shit.
He kind of, because they walked in when you had all the gold in your hand and such, and he was like, "Well, it looks like you had a load anyway."
Nah, that doesn't count. Well, those are spoils of war. We're talking about reward money now. Two different things.
Well,
this saved your town from an evil skeleton man taking over with this necromancer shit. And you're gonna skimp out on the rewards for saving the town? Wow. I cannot believe my eyes.
Right, I'm sorry, we meant no offense, great adventurer. Let us just scour around, see what we've got left for you, okay?
What do you mean left? We didn't take anything.
Yes, but
this
we don't...
This is something totally different. We know you gotta run this town somehow, and all these guards got some pretty nice armor.
That's because it was being funded by Fred Wu. Now
he's... Yeah, well, he's dead, so take whatever Fred Wu had that he was funding shit with.
We don't know what he's got left. That's the thing. We're gonna need a bit of time just to find out. Right. Well, if you all would like to go rest up, we'll get back to you as soon as we can.
Oh yeah, there's this innkeeper. He's a snitch-ass bitch.
Don't you know who's snitching?
He just went into the back room, alright?
Definitely a snitch.
Let's just leave the innkeeper, okay?
What about the resistance leader? What are they resisting anyway?
They were resisting Fred Wu because they believed that he was a skeleton, but no one believed him.
Oh, wow. Well, you better go get them. They seem pretty goddamn capable, huh? Maybe they know how to properly give out some fucking rewards, too. For killing skelly men.
Well, there's not much resistance left. Most of them are dead.
Well, that's a good fucking thing y'all did, huh?
I pick up Mage and I'll just walk out.
He's on my shoulders.
Yeah, you can't reach me up here, can you?
I'm good.
And I do.
I'm gonna cast the.
You don't know yet. You don't know yet. I've just joined you. And we're going.
Cast some spider climb on Andy's back and leave nothing.
You're not on Andy's back anymore. I took you off of it.
I wanna go. I wanna.
As Marceline walks past, kind of holding Midge, one of the guards kind of make a comment. So now they've got two kids to look after.
Oh God! Okay, hold on, pause. We're just casting spider shit on us, and we're slapping that wall so we stop, and we're summoning something. About to whoop some ass.
I just keep dragging as fast as I can.
Okay, I'm stuck to the wall now, like Spider-Man.
You went on a wall.
Sticking to something.
Good. Okay.
Yeah, me probably.
I can still cast. I'm gonna cast an acid ball at that asshole's head.
God.
Make an attack roll.
Oh damn.
You missed. It goes flying past his head. He kind of goes. He goes. Whoa. What the fuck?
You're talking shit, bitch. Gonna get hit. Fucking mouse writing checks your ass can't handle, huh? I'm gonna summon a boar now.
Does someone want to deal with this?
Can I summon a boar? Threaten him until I get a proper apology?
I'm sorry, Jesus Christ, I'm sorry.
Better be.
Alright, let's go, Mitch. I'll buy you a drink.
Gotta go meet up with this snitch-ass bartender again.
Wow. Okay, so you'll go back to the inn. It is technically night. So you will wake up the next morning. And you will have been given a free stay at the inn for starters. And
are we full health now?
No.
After a night's sleep or not full health?
No, you
get like plus one.
Yeah, so you don't. Yeah, in Pathfinder you don't get much. In 5th edition you get full health again. Okay, so however, the next morning you come downstairs and you are greeted by those guards again.
Oh God.
And they are carrying chests with them. They're carrying 7 chests.
Never mind.
and they plop them down. They open them up and they go. 2,000 in each. Consider this your reward.
Sweet shit.
Thank you.
No, this is all we could find now.
Many thanks.
Right, okay. Right. Usable. So what? So now,
Mr. Color.
Now,
Thank you.
And also for the next up to 10 days, we've arranged it so you can stay in this tavern and eat here for free. so long as you don't, you know, run the place into the ground, so to speak.
You think noble adventurers like such as us would run this place into the ground?
Yes.
Okay, yeah. You want to go around too, guard boy? Let's go.
No. It's, no,
right, it,
no.
Right now.
We have had... No, listen. Before you guys came here, we had another group of adventurers who passed through, and they just expected everything for free, and expected us just to do everything they wanted. So, it's nothing against you, it's just from our past experience, okay?
Ookie dookie.
It was a group of, like, five, six people, kind of adorned in, like really kind of, like, fancy equipment.
Oh, it was those fucking dicks.
Yeah, the guys who noticed that.
Those assholes.
That guy was the necromancer, though.
What?
That guy was the necromancer.
Glad someone remembered. Nope.
So I thought you guys were talking about tieflings from the last.
The tieflings and the half elves.
Those assholes passing through. I wonder what they were up to.
Okay, so now, honest question: is anyone wanting to particularly do anything until Valden's armored coat is ready? Is anyone wanting to order anything?
Yeah, where can a nigga go and get healed up for free?
It's called Jonathan, or
yeah.
Masley.
I might want to stop by the church, try to talk my way into getting some free healing, Jankums.
Jonathan! Your guy! Your paladins can heal.
Yeah, that's gonna waste his one day.
We're not probably gonna do anything today.
Yeah. To be fair, you probably won't.
Heal up then.
This is gonna be downtime.
Right. Well, I suppose it depends. Are you wanting to do anything in particular until Valden gets his armored coat?
I kind of want to order stuff, maybe.
Right.
I need to go check him. I need to go look through some pages.
Well, what do you want to order in particular? I will assume that over the week you will all go back to max hit points.
I don't know, Aaron, is there any, like, magic staffs I can get that might, you know, do something cool for me? Or is... No, not really.
Define cool.
Helpful?
Well, what exactly do you want to do?
Something helpful, I don't know.
Shit, nigga, I don't know.
Staffs are... The thing is, the staffs only have, like, so many charges of, like, spells, and then that's it.
How many charges we talking here?
Usually not many.
Dang.
Alright, what does it get a headband?
A headband?
Yeah. You know which one I'm talking about.
I don't actually.
Hey, what's the one with the leaf village?
Oh, for God's sake.
This sort of shit. Am I looking at the normal price, or am I looking at the crafting price?
It would be the normal.
Fuck!
Aaron, I want something that makes it so my strength isn't -2. How much would that cost?
Well, it's not -2, it's at 0.
No, it's a -2, because I'm small. I'm a gnome.
Yeah, but that was... That's 12 went to 10 because of the -2.
No, that 12, it was already a 0.
No.
Yeah, it was at 10, now it's at 8.
No, it was at 12, now it's at 10. Trust me on this.
Okay.
Yeah, but I think it works out better for you either way, so... you can... Well, technically you can, but it does cost quite a bit. So essentially you want one of those, Andy.
Well, it was, but since it's not going to cost 8 grand, it's going to cost 16, I'm probably not going to get it now.
Alright, so, what do you think
about some nice Master Cooper Hidden Thieves clothes?
Jesus. Right, so, does anyone want to get anything?
No.
Master Cooper Hidden Thieves.
Can I get some...
Hmm?
Would Masterwork Mithril Full Plate be decent?
Masterwork Mithril Full Plate. Ooh.
I'm going for that.
Hold up, how much money do you have to spend?
I have $8,000.
Ooh, let me have a look. Just make sure that it's... You've actually
I don't know if the mithril's worth it, though. That's what I'm thinking. Because it's just the same as my banded mail, really. Just more AC.
Right, hang on, sorry.
And my banded mail's not masterwork.
Right, hang on. Sorry. You don't have enough.
Wow! Alright, well,
okay. Okay. Hang on, sorry. One second. If you want masterwork full plate, that's mithril, it would cost you 10,650 gold pieces.
Jesus!
You could ask your colleagues if they wouldn't mind giving you a bit of money that you will pay them back later.
Oh, that's alright.
How much is it?
How much is...
Do it.
Masterwork...
Well, I don't got anything to buy anyway at this point. I can't carry anything else.
Master...
You give me like $2,000.
Master...
Yeah, I'll give you $2,000. I don't give a shit.
A masterwork mithril full plate?
Is it even worth it though? That's what I'm asking.
Okay, the masterwork and mithril would take the armature penalty down to -2. The weight of it would be 25. And, it counts as, medium armor. Because mithril makes it one size category less.
But I still move slow anyway.
Yeah.
So, I just don't see the point in that.
Am I taking out 2,000 or not, Andy?
Well, hang on, Andy, what's your dex bonus, sorry?
Dex bonus is 1.
Right, because the mithril also makes it +3.
I'm probably never going to get to fucking +2, to be honest. That's why I was thinking just leaving it as just masterwork full plate.
Yeah, but then with the masterwork full plate, you can then... start putting like +1s on it afterwards.
Yeah. I know that.
And if you actually want to make it +1, then that would be...
But +1 doesn't add anything to AC, does it?
Yeah, +1 adds it one does. To AC, yeah.
Ooh, how much would that be?
sorry, let me have a think. $11,500.
Whoa! Why is armor so expensive?
Okay, it's the mithril.
No, I don't want to make it mithril. Fuck mithril.
Oh, you don't want to make it mithril? So you're
no, I just add +1s to it.
So you're fine with it being at -5 armature penalty because of masterwork and weighing 50 pounds?
I don't use skills anyway. And I can carry everything!
That's a good point. Okay, so a +1 full plate is 2,500. If you want to make that +2, that's 5,500. And that would give you a +11 to AC. But that would take a few days to be made, but it would be, if you did it early on, it would be made before his armored coat would be made.
I'll just go full plate +1 masterwork.
Alright.
I don't know why they don't do the mithril.
Andy. The masterwork is part of the +1.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, so it's a +1 full plate, so it's 2,500 gold.
Okay.
And once that's made, that'll be a +10 to your AC from armor, -5 armor check penalty. It weighs 50 pounds.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
Does anyone else want anything else? Any other kind of upgrades? The thing is, I know Michael would want kind of to upgrade his gun, but he needs to find someone to upgrade his gun.
Find someone, yeah.
Yeah.
I was thinking, I won't be bothered with my armor.
Willie, you should probably upgrade your armor, dude.
What armor did you
even have?
Band and mail plus one.
Band and mail plus one, right.
Ew, Aaron.
Mm-hmm.
My gnome character gets like a plus two to a craft, and I haven't picked a craft yet. Could I learn how to make potions?
Yeah, sure. Sure.
While we're here, if
you
have any
feet, don't you? Brew potion.
Fuck. I've got no feet. I only got two
Actually,
feet.
Yeah, that's a good point. craft is things like weapons and armor and stuff like that. And no, you've got 3 feet.
Like, left to choose?
No, you've got 3 feet. You've got extra gnome magic, extra summons, and summon good monster.
Oh no, I was joking, like, I only have 2 feet, like, connected to my legs.
Oh, sorry, I know what you meant, sorry. But yeah, but yeah, that's fine. Anything else that people want?
No, I'm good.
No, okay. So, what I'm going to say is the time will pass up to the point that Adam will get his armored coat. You could, by the way, Andy, you could sell your armor to this guy just to get a bit back. So,
sure. Oh, I also need to sell that greatsword as well.
Oh, yes, you do. People have weapons to sell as well. So, everyone with one of those magic weapons will get a grand for them.
Oh.
And then, Andy, for your banded mail, you'll get
it's a bit worn.
You'll get about 100 back for it.
100 gold.
Yeah.
Dang.
Well, banded mail is 250 standard.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. And then Adam, for your padded, you'll get like, is yours just ordinary padded?
Yeah. Oh, padded master. Sorry.
Padded masterwork. Okay, so you will get about 75 gold back. And now you have your plus. It's plus two armored coat, isn't it? Yeah, it is. It's plus two armored coat. Yeah. So you have your plus two armored coat, which is plus two mithril armored coat. Sorry, which is plus six armor bonus, maximum of plus five dex, no armor check penalty, and waste 10 pounds. And it counts as light armor, for the purposes of movement. So, it does not impede your movement at all, so long as you are not encumbered.
Cool. Encumbered anyway.
Yeah. But that's because of what you're hauling around in your bag, aren't you? Which you could easily just keep on your wagon. So once again, anyone want anything? Last chance.
Wait, is it plus six ammo bonus?
It's plus six because your coat.
Do my braces still count?
Yeah, your braces count on top of that, yeah. So that's plus seven in total.
Yeah.
Oh, hang on. What braces do you have, sorry?
Braces of armor, it just says that.
Sorry, one second. One second. Sorry. Let me just check. Oh no, your braces of armor cease functioning. They do not stack on top. I mean, the upside is you can give them to like Willow, who can't have armor, and just say, "Here you go."
I see he has improved quite a lot.
Yeah. So you've had to give up. So could someone just make a note that a Willow's been given the braces of armor?
I'll just keep them on me until next.
Alright, that's fine, that's how I work, if that's how you want to work. So,
the hell is that noise?
And Andy, like I mentioned, your new armor will give you a plus 10 to your armor bonus.
Yeah.
Instead of the plus 7 from before. So, we're going to call the session there. And, like I mentioned to you guys before, if it's good with Will, we'll do Will's campaign starting next week for a few weeks. Mm-hmm. So, in terms of experience, I'm going to give everyone in the party, at least present, I'm going to give you all 3,000 XPs. Has anyone leveled up?
I think so.
I think 10,000 more.
Wait, what was that, Michael?
Yeah, I leveled up.
What level are you now, Michael?
I just got 36,000, so I'm...
7. So. Yeah, you're...
Y'all hear me?
No. No, we
y'all can't hear me?
Well, we can hear you now, but we couldn't before.
I don't know, my fucking headset's like turning on and off or some shit.
No, that's cool. So, for Will's campaign, it's going to be level 1 characters to begin with, we've decided. Dakota, do you want me, if we can talk tomorrow or Monday, one of the two, to help you kind of with, to help you make the Eidolon for my campaign and then kind of go through the 5th edition stuff again?
Sure, whatever you feel like doing, dude.
Alright, well I'll be on tomorrow anyway. Right, anyway, I want to thank everyone on YouTube.